forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon for my latest update. Welcome back to my channel. In our last video, we have seen marketing part 1, where we have dealt with the meaning of marketing, marketing definition given by authors, concept, 4 P's of marketing, importance of marketing, and finally marketing practices in India. But in our last video, we haven't covered some of the points which we are going to cover in this video, which is nature and scope of marketing, functions of marketing, perceptives of marketing, and finally modern marketing concept. Let us start with a quick revision on the term marketing. What is marketing? Marketing is the performance of business activities that direct the flow of goods and services from producer to consumer or the end user. The term marketing is not only about shopping, selling, advertising, product planning, distribution, standard of living. It's more than that. Actually, marketing is a comprehensive term and it includes all resources and set of activities necessary to direct and facilitate the flow of goods and services from producer to the customer, including after sales service in the process of distribution. Hence, we can conclude the objective of marketing is to ascertain consumer needs, convert the need into ideas, ideas into the product and services, and the final product and services are distributed or sold among the consumer or the end user to satisfy certain needs and wants of specific consumer segments with emphasis on profitability. As the main aim of any organization is to earn the profit, ensuring the optimal use of the resources available to the organization. Now we will move toward nature of marketing. In nature of marketing, first we have marketing is an economical function. Second, we have marketing is a legal process by which ownership are transferred. Third, we have marketing is a system of interacting business activities. Fourth, we have marketing is a managerial function. Fifth, we have marketing is a social process. Sixth, we have marketing is a philosophy based on consumer orientation and satisfaction. Seventh, we have marketing had dual objective. First, profit making, and second, consumer satisfaction. Let us see these points in detail. First, we have marketing is an economical function. How it's an economical function? Marketing focus on all the business activities involved in getting goods and services from the hand of producer into the hand of final consumers. So here we can conclude marketing is an economical function as it have to focus on the customer present in the market as per their needs and demand. Organization have to go through manufacture or the production process, and as the per their interest, they produce the goods and services and finally they sell it to the market and satisfy the customer's need. Second point we have, marketing is a legal process by which ownership is transferred. As we all know, in a market, whenever we pay the amount for the goods and services, we get the ownership of the product or the services for which the amount we have paid. Similarly, this point say, marketing is a process by which ownership of the goods and services are transferred from seller to purchaser or from producer to the end user. Third point we have, marketing is a system of interacting business activities. Marketing is that process through which a business enterprises, institution or organization interacts with the customers and stakeholders with the objective to earn profit, satisfy customers' needs, and manage relationship. It is the performance of business activities that direct the flow of goods and services from producer to consumer or end users. We all know in a market, people need to interact with each other, whether it's seller to buyer or buyer to seller, or even to the organization person who has came for observation or research. Everyone need to interact to know more and to get more information, ideas, so that they can get the demand of the market, they can understand the requirement of the market, and as per the requirement, as per the need, they can go through the production process and they can make a better decision. Fourth point we have, marketing is a managerial function. What's a managerial function? According to managerial or system approach, marketing is the combination of activities designed to produce profit through ascertaining, creating, stimulating, and satisfying the need and want of the selected segment of the market. According to this nature, marketing focuses on knowing how an individual organization process and develop the strategy so that they can know more about the market and the need of the customer, and as per their need and requirement, they can go through their production process. So it's a managerial function. Fifth point we have, marketing is a social process. How it's a social process? Because marketing focuses on knowing and understanding the customer's changing needs and wants. Marketing helps in efficiently and effectively managing the supply and demand of products and services. Marketing helps in efficient provision of distribution and payment process system. Marketing is concerned with the people, by the people, for the people in a market, so it's a social process. Sixth we have, marketing is a philosophy based on consumer orientation and satisfaction. Marketing starts and ends with the customer. Under customer-oriented marketing, it is most essential to know the requirement or the demand of customer, or to understand what customer actually wants. This is possible only when the information is collected from the customer. Thus, it is the start of marketing. The marketing ends as soon as the goods or services reaches into the hand of customer. Hence, marketing is based on customer orientation and satisfaction. Seventh point we have, marketing had dual objective. First, profit making, and second, consumer satisfaction. As we all know, every organization focuses on one thing, which is to make the profit at the end, and second, customer satisfaction. Customer satisfaction can only be achieved if organization understand the need and requirement of the market or the customers. And as per the requirement or the need of the customer, company go through the production process and they produce the relevant goods and services so that the demand of customers can be fulfilled. After nature of marketing, we will see scope of marketing. Here in scope of marketing, first we have study of consumer wants and needs. Second, we have study of consumer behavior. Third, we have production planning and development. Fourth, we have pricing policies. Five, we have distribution. Six, we have promotion. Seventh, we have consumer satisfaction. And last, we have marketing control. Let us see them in detail. First, we have study of consumer wants and needs. Goods are produced to satisfy consumer wants. Therefore, study is done to identify consumer needs and wants. These needs and wants motivate consumer to purchase. In absence of need and desire for the product, consumer will not be motivated to buy the product, as every person wants to save their money. So it's very important for an organization to go through a study or a research to understand the consumer wants and needs before going to the production process. Next point we have, study of consumer behavior. Marketers perform study of consumer behavior. Analyzing of buyer behavior helps marketer in market segmentation and targeting customers. Study of consumer behavior is very important to know because every organization wants to understand the demand and the need requirement of the customer so that they can go through the production process. If without understanding or without going through a study of consumer behavior, they will produce the goods or services, maybe the customers will not get attracted toward the product. They will behave negatively. So it's important to study consumer behavior before starting the production process. Third, we have production planning and development. Production planning and development starts with the generation of product idea and ends with the product development and commercialization. Production planning includes everything from branding and packaging to production line expansion and contraction. Whereas production development focuses on developing the existing product, whether development is done in the test or packaging style or the quality or quantity, but development to make it better and to attract more and more customer. Fourth, we have pricing policies. Marketer has to determine pricing policies for their products. Pricing policies differ from product to product. It depends on the level of competition, product life cycle, marketing goals and objectives, etc. Five, we have distribution. Study of distribution channel is important in marketing. For maximum sale and profit, goods are required to be distributed to maximum consumer at minimum cost. Six, we have promotion. Promotion includes personal selling, sales promotion and advertising. Right promotion mix is crucial in accomplishment of marketing goal, as promotion make customers aware about the product so that they can know the product and further they can show their interest in purchasing the product. Seventh, we have consumer satisfaction. The product or service offered must satisfy consumer. Consumer satisfaction is the major objective of marketing, as the overall profit of the organization depend on the interest of buyers. When they will buy the product, then only company can get the profit or company can manage to get the amount which they have invested in production process. Eight, we have marketing control. Marketing audit is done to control the marketing activities. Now, after scope of marketing, we will move toward functions of marketing. In functions of marketing, we are going to see 12 points. First, gathering and analyzing market information. Second, marketing planning. Third, product designing and development. Four, standardization and grading. Five, packaging and labeling. Six, branding. Seven, customer support service. 8. Pricing of products. 9. Promotion. 10. Physical distribution. 11. Transportation. And finally, storage or warehousing. Let us see them in detail. First point we have is gathering and analyzing market information. Gathering and analyzing market information is an important function of marketing. Under it, an effort is made to understand the customer completely. It contains information such as what do the customer want, in what quantity, at what price, when do they want, what kind of advertisement do they like, where do they want it, and so on. Second point we have marketing planning. In order to achieve the objective of an organization with regards to its marketing, the marketer chalks out his marketing plan. For example, a company has a 25% market share of a particular product. The company wants to raise it to 40%. In order to achieve this objective, the marketer has to prepare a plan in respect of the level of production and promotion efforts. It will also be decided as to who will do what, when, and how. To do this, we need to know marketing planning. Third point we have, product designing and development. Product designing plays an important role in product selling. The company whose product is better and attractive designed sell more than the product of a company whose design happens to be weak and unattractive. In this way, we can say when a company develops or generates such a strategy, such a design, such a packaging for their product which attract the customer or which are liked by the customer will bring out more interest and demand among customers. It is also important to remember that it is not sufficient to prepare a design in respect of a product, but it is more important to develop it continuously over the time. Fourth point we have, standardization and grading. Standardization refers to determining of standard regarding size, quality, design, weight, color, raw materials to be used, etc. in respect of a particular product. By doing so, the product will attract more and more customer with their different and standard quality product. Fifth, we have packaging and labeling. Packaging aims at avoiding breakage, damage, destruction, etc. of the goods during transit and storage. Packaging facilitates handling, lifting, conveying of goods. Many a time, customers demand goods in different quantities. It necessitates special packaging. Packaging material includes bottle, cans, plastic bags, tins or wooden boxes, jute bags, etc. Label is a slip which is found on the product itself or on the package, providing all information regarding the product and its producer. This can be either in the form of a cover or a seal. Six, we have branding. Every seller or producer wants that his product should have special identity in the market. In order to realize his wish, he has to give a name to his product, which has to be distinct from other competitors. Giving of distinct name to one's product is called branding. Thus, the objective of branding is to show that the products of a given company are different from that of the competitors, so that it has its own identity. Seventh point we have, customer support service. As we all know, customer is the king on the market. Therefore, it is one of the chief function of the marketers to offer every possible help to the customers. A marketer offer primarily the following services to the customer, such as after sales services, handling customers' complaints, technical services, credit facilities, maintenance services, etc. 8. We have pricing of products. It is the most important function of a marketing manager to fix price of a product. The price of a product is affected by its cost, rate of profit, price of substitute product, policy of the government, etc. The price of product should be fixed in a manner that it should not appear to be too high, and at the same time it should earn enough profit for the organization. Ninth point we have, promotion. Promotion means informing the customer about the product of the company and encouraging them to buy these products. There are four methods of promotion. First, advertising. Second, personal selling. Third, sales promotion. And fourth, publicity. Every decision taken by the marketer in this respect affects the sale. These decisions can be taken by keeping in view the budget of the company. Next point we have physical distribution. Under this function of marketing, the decision about carrying things from the place of production to the place of consumption is taken into account. To accomplish this task, decision about four factors are taken. They are transportation, inventory, warehousing, and order processing. Physical distribution, by taking things at the right place at the right time, creates time and place utility. 11th point we have transportation. Production, sell, and consumption. All the three activities need not be at one place. Here, product is carried out at one place, selling of product at another place, and consumption at another. Transport facility is needed for the produced goods to reach in the hand of consumers. So the enterprise must have an easy access to means of transportation. Mostly we have seen on roadside private vehicles belonging to Pepsi, Coca-Cola, Britannia, etc. These private vehicles are the live example of transportation function of marketing. 12th point we have storage or warehousing. There is a time lag between the purchase or production of goods and their sale. It is very essential to store the goods at the safe place during this time interval. Godowns are used for this purpose. Keeping of goods in godowns till the same are sold is called storage. For the marketing manager, storage is an important function. Any negligence on his part may damage the entire stock. Time utility is thus created by storage activity. After functions of marketing, we will move toward four perceptives of marketing. First, we have economic perspective. The economic perspective explains the flow of goods and services from the producer to the customers so as to match supply and demand and thereby accomplish the objective of society. Here, the economist emphasizes two specific marketing functions, promotion and distribution. But he fails to recognize the broader role of marketing within a given society. Next, we have business perspective. It refers to designing a product or service, setting a price, promoting and distributing. A business firm utilizes all these four functions in order to satisfy the customers. In other words, marketing performs the process of adjusting the resources of a business firm to meet the need of the market. Third, we have customer perspective. Customer perspective emphasizes that marketing is more concerned with the standpoint of customer, that is, his needs and wants, the price he is required to pay, the service and utilities, etc. Under this perspective, organization focus on customer's need, marketing research, product development, pricing, and distribution. Fourth point we have, social perspective. In this perspective, organization not only think about making profit, but also think about making the goodwill of the organization. We have seen several times that organization is making some of the institution, they are making parks, they are making some facilities for the consumers or for the society. So these all activities come under social perspective. After perspectives of marketing, now we will move toward modern marketing concept. The modern marketing concept, as suggested by Philip Kotler, holds the key to achieve the need and wants of target markets and delivering the desired satisfaction more effectively and efficiently. Here basically we will see the four components. They are first, target market; second, needs of customer; third, coordinated marketing; and last, profitability. Let us see them in detail. First, we have target market. It is not possible for a company to operate in every market and satisfy every need of the customer. It is not possible to do a good job within one broad market, but it's possible for an organization to develop the production process and to bring out new changes so that the customer could be attracted toward the organization product. The main aim of every company should be not to let their target customer to shift to other competitors. They should create certain techniques, certain strategies. They should bring certain offers, or they should make changes in their packaging or the quality and the test of the product, so that the customers will not shift to other product. They will remain motivated to buy the organization product. So it's very important for any organization to understand their target customer needs and choices. And as per their demand, it's very important for an organization to bring out the changes so that customer won't feel bored with their product and they won't think of shifting to other. Second point, we have needs of customer. For any organization, it is very important to understand the demand and needs of customer. After understanding the need and demand of customer, an organization can take better decision while selecting the product to produce in their organization. Third point, we have coordinated marketing. It is a pity that most employees in an organization are not trained and motivated to work for the customer. This is why there is almost always need for coordinated marketing. Such marketing means two things. First, the various marketing function, sales promotion, advertising, product management, pricing market, research, and so on must be coordinated among them, keeping in view the need of customers. Second, marketing must be well coordinated with the other company departments. Marketing work only when all employees appreciate the impact they have on the customer satisfaction. Fourth point, we have profitability. The ultimate purpose of the whole marketing concept is to help organization to achieve their goals. So it is absolutely essential for marketers to be involved in analyzing the profit potential of different marketing opportunities. Or in simple word, we can say an organization should analyze what is the need of the market, what is the demand of the customers, and as per their requirement, they can go to the production process. And this analysis is going to help them to select the right product to manufacture in their organization. So with this, we have completed our another video on marketing part 2. For more related videos, don't forget to have a look on my channel. Thank you.